What's going on, TTC? Well, just finished watching Georgia bring the wood to Louisville. Georgia wins this game 37-14. Quite frankly, the score was not even as close as that. Louisville was never really in this game at all. That last drive they put together, we just was in the prevent the whole fucking drive. So, of course, they went down the field. But, you know, the sack at the end of the game still kept them out of the end zone. Nick, what can you say about Nick Chubb? Career night for him, 267 yards on the ground, two touchdowns, averaged over 8 yards a carry. Jesus Christ. He finished the season. They showed the stat. It was like 1,549 yards or something. But he finished second in school history as far as rushing yards in a single season. Herschel has the top three records, but that mark actually surpassed Garrison Hurst by, was it 1 yard, I think? 1 or 2 yards. the scary thing is, guys, I mean, Nick Chubb was not even a starter at the beginning of this year. I mean, it's. I think it's safe to say if he would have started the beginning of the season, I mean, we all knew Todd Gurley was the guy, but let's just play that what-if game. What if Nick Chubb started from day one? There's no question in my mind. I think he would probably have passed Herschel's 1,860 mark or something like that. He would have passed that. And the thing is, it's like Todd Gurley, his freshman year in 2012, he actually had an extra game to get his numbers. Because remember, that was the year we went to the SEC championship. Nick Chubb did what he did in a game less than Todd Gurley did his freshman season. And he wasn't even the damn fucking starter the first half of the season. That was crazy. Our defense played lights out this game. A couple interceptions. We got like 3 or 4 quarterback sacks. Jeremy Pruitt, he got these guys ready to play. Feels great beating the hell out of Todd Grantham. I've been saying it all fucking year long. Louisville had one of those top-ranked defenses because they didn't hardly play any fucking body. You know, when they played, you know, good teams, well, they got exposed. And, well, we exposed their asses tonight. I'm going to be honest here. There were still some things I was not pleased with. Late in the third and even into the fourth quarter, it was clear we were trying to burn clock, but situational play calling was still an issue here in this game. Running Brendan Douglas on these key series, I mean, he's our third string running back right now, and he's not the guy to get those key carries when you need it. I mean, he's just not. He's great to close out a game, but he's not that guy when it actually matters. I'm willing to admit that. And there were a couple of those drives where I still, you know, still think we should have kept pushing and tried for a touchdown. And then I think one of those drives we didn't even get a field goal out of it because they kept Douglas in. And I didn't get that. I was really disappointed with that shit. So there were some moments in this game I was not pleased with, but overall you cannot argue with the outcome. 37-14, it was a hell of a win. That makes the SEC 4-1 in their bowl games right now. Thanks a lot, LSU, for fucking it up and losing it to Notre Dame. I mean, how the Golson had like 60 yards passing in that game and you fuckers lost. How the fuck do you lose to Notre Dame? That goddamn. And I'm going to make this little shout-out real quick to my boy All About the U83, Jay, Bo Nose. That's how you beat Louisville, guys. I know we've been going back and forth a lot on the radio shows all year long and whatever, so, you know, I had to throw that little shot in there. But, yeah, can't argue with the outcome. We end the season with 10 wins. I'm pleased with that. Overall, it still sucks that we didn't make it to the SEC championship game, but getting 10 wins is not easy, guys. I mean, a lot of teams would kill for that. You know, I mean, we did end the season on a positive note. Hopefully, with Nick Chubb starting next year, hopefully we could actually make it back to Atlanta. I think anybody with a brain knows that Georgia was the best team in the East this year, and hopefully we can continue to be that team come next year. We'll have to see. But, well, damn, time flies. It just seemed like yesterday I was doing hate weeks for Clemson, but that's going to do it for the 2014 UGA football season. That's hard to say. I mean, got to wait all the way until next year, but hey, it is what it is. Great win for Georgia. Todd Grantham, you can go suck a bulldog nutsack, motherfucker. That's about it. We'll holler at y'all next time, and go Dawgs.